There's a place called Vyasapothi in Badrinath or Badrikashrama, and the speciality of this place is it's shaped in the form of palm leaf manuscripts or Talapatra Granthas. It is said that in this gufa or cave, Maharishi Vedavyas wrote the Vedas, the Mahabharata and the Puranas. So in this video today, let's talk about the Puranas. Namaste everyone, welcome back to Zesty Nimbu, this is Shrirekha. As we have seen in Upanga's video, Puranas are one of the four Upangas. There are Ashtadasha Mahapuranas or 18 Mahapuranas and there are many Upapuranas as well. Today let's talk about the Ashtadasha Mahapuranas. But before that, let's understand the importance of Puranas. As we have seen in the Upanga's video, Puranas are said to be like the magnifying glass of the Vedas. They extol the virtues of the Vedas in the form of stories, the form of conversation between people. And unlike the Vedas, where certain conditions have to be met by the person who is studying them, the Puranas don't have any conditions. It can be read by any person. It can be read by man, woman, child. It can be heard by anybody. And that is where the importance of Puranas lies, because it has been transmitted to each person of this country. And because of the Puranas, the dharmic values and the Vedic society as we see today is still standing. And hence, Puranas are considered even more valuable than the Vedas. With the help of these Puranas, the Vedic language and the dharmic values have reached the masses. In our ancient temples, there are Vyakhyana Mandapas or Mandapas which are outside the temple, which were used by scholars to tell these Puranas to the masses. People used to come and gather every day in front of the scholar who will talk about the Puranas. This is how the Vedic society and dharmic values of the Vedas were extolled to the masses. That is the importance of Puranas. What is Purana? Purana means Pura Navam Bhavati. That means that through which old becomes new again. So Puranas are ancient, but it is modified to suit the modern needs of humans. And that is the beauty of the Puranas. When we talk about Puranas, we need to remember two people. Vedavyasa, who wrote the Puranas, who actually condensed the 100 crore shlokas into 4 lakh shlokas, and into 18 Mahapuranas and various Upapuranas. And the other person is Vidyaranyaswami, who is the commentator of all the Vedas and who wrote an abridged version of all the Puranas called Puranasara. These two people have to be remembered for their contribution. So I had mentioned in our Hindu scriptures video about the Puranas, and I said there's a shloka with which we can remember the Ashtadasha Mahapuranas. The shloka goes like this. Madhvayam Bhadvayam Chaiva Bhratrayam Vachastushtayam Anapalinga Kuskani Puranani Pruthak Pruthak. So if you see the words Madhvayam, the first letter is Ma. So there are two Puranas with the letter Ma, which is Matsya Purana and Markandeya Purana. The next word is Bhadvayam Chaiva, where the first letter is Bha. So there are two Puranas with Bha letter, Bhavishya Purana and Bhagavata Purana or Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhratrayam, the letter is Bra, and there are three Puranas with the letter Bra. Brahma Purana, Brahma Vaivarta Purana and Brahmanda Purana. Vajastushtayam, so the letter is Va. There are four Puranas, Vayu Purana, Vishnu Purana, Vamana Purana and Varaha Purana. Anapalinga Kuskani, so in this A is Agni Purana, Na is Narada Purana, Pa is Padma Purana, Li is Linga Purana, Ga is Garuda Purana, Ku Kurma Purana and Ska is Kanda Purana. So this is mentioned in the Devi Bhagavata, which gives the names of the 18 Puranas with the shloka. So these 18 Mahapuranas can be divided into three types. One is Satvika, which talks about or extols the virtues of Vishnu. One type is the Rajasa Puranas, which extols the virtues of Shiva. And the third one is Tamasa Puranas, which talk or extol the virtues of other gods. So these are the three varieties of Puranas that we have. Each Purana, the 18 Puranas that I have mentioned, each of them have some common Lakshanas. There are 5 such common lakshanas. And apart from these 5, each of them can have other lakshanas as well. Like Bhagavata Purana has 10 lakshanas. But there are 5 which are very common to all the Ashtadasha Mahapuranas. And it can be described with the help of a shloka. The shloka goes like this. Sargascha Pratisargascha Vamsho Manvantaranicha Vamshanucharitam Chaiva Puranam Pancha Lakshanam. So what are the 5 lakshanas mentioned? One is Sargaha, which means creation. Second is Pratisargaha, that means the destruction, periodic annihilation and recreation of the world as we see. So the third is Vamshaha, which talks about the genealogy of sages and devatas, the Rishi Vamsha and the Vamsha of the devatas. The fourth is Manvantara. Now this Manvantara concept, we have covered this in our Sankalpa Mantra video. So there are 2 parts to that video. You can go ahead and see those 2 parts to understand this concept better. So the Manvantara talks about the cosmic cycles which are presided by various Manus. We are in the Vaivaswata Manu or Vaivaswata Manvantara, which is presided over by Vaivaswata Manu, right? And the last is Vamsacharitam, which talks about the dynasties of all the kings of Bharatvarsha, which provides historical accounts of all the royal dynasties of Bharatvarsha. So these are the 5 lakshanas that we have in all the Puranas. Various Mahapuranas talk about the kinds of pilgrimages that one has to undertake, what are the pilgrimage spots, and the vratas and the pujas that everybody does, like the Satyanarayana Vrata, Vinayaka Chaviti or the Ganesh Puja that we do, and Ram Navami celebrations that we do, the Dasara celebrations. Now it is Navratri time, so how to do the Navratri Puja, how to do Deepavali Puja, how to do Vijayadashami. All the kinds of pujas have been mentioned, all the kinds of pilgrimages have been mentioned in the Puranas. So now let's see briefly about all these Puranas. So first is the Brahma Purana. The Brahma Purana describes the formation of universe and other formations. It talks about the oldest Manu, who is Swayambhu Manu, and his wife Satrupa and various other Prajapatis. It talks about various continents of the world, and the other Manvantaras are also discussed. It talks about various lokas like Swargaloka, Brahmaloka, Bhuloka, etc. It also talks about the sacred places of India. And it gives a great description of Utkala or Orissa, which is described in the Brahma Purana. Now let's see the next Purana, which is Padma Purana. So Padma Purana is divided into 5 parts. The first is Srushti Khanda, which talks about the birth of Brahma in Padma. And Brahma is given a great prominence in this Purana, which is not present in any other Purana. It describes Shraddha ceremonies and it describes in depth about Gaya. It also talks about creation in the form of Sankhya tradition. Padma Purana also talks about Masa Mahatyam, where the importance of various months are mentioned. Now we have Vishnu Purana. Vishnu Purana is narrated by Parashara, and he describes the Vishnu Purana to sage Maitreya. Parashara is the father of Vedavyasa. So it is also divided into 6 parts and again subdivided into many parts. The first part talks about creation, about Purusha and Prakriti, etc. This also gives the various avatars of Vishnu. It also gives final judgments, like say Kali is a Sadhu Yuga. In Vishnu Purana is mentioned that Kali is a good time, and if you do anything good, you'll get all the Punya. If you think anything good, you'll get Punya. But if you think anything bad, you'll not get any Pap. But if you do any bad deed, then obviously you'll get Pap. So Kali is a good time. So these kind of things are mentioned in Vishnu Purana. Now let's talk about Brahma Vaivarta Purana. So Brahma Vaivarta Purana is divided into 4 parts and it gives a description about Krishna and Radha. So whoever is interested in understanding about Radha and Krishna, they can read Brahma Vaivarta Purana. Now let's talk about Vayu Purana. So Vayu Purana is an interesting Purana. It talks about creation and recreation of the universe. It talks about measurement of time from Suryodaya to Suryodaya. That means sunrise to sunrise. That's how we Indians calculate the day. It talks about the origins of Agni and other gods. It talks about rishis like Atri, Bhrigu, Angirasa and others. It talks about ancient kings who have come from Vaivatsvata Manu and the various dynasties of those kings. It also talks about Rakshasas, Gandharvas, lower animals, birds, plants, creepers, etc. Vayupurana talks about Gupta dynasty which comes in Kali Yuga. It's a great thing, so it predicts the Gupta dynasty as well. Next, we'll come to Narada Purana. Narada Purana is one of the Vaishnava Puranas. It is divided into two parts. First part is actually a Upapurana called Brihanaradhya Purana. Narada is the sage who has actually initiated Valmiki and Vyasa to write about Ramayana and Mahabharata. Right? So, if there is an important work to be undertaken, Narada is the first person who goes and initiates people into that work. So, it talks about Narada Rishi as well. So, Narada Purana talks about Narada and it talks about various Vishnu Bhakti topics. So, next Purana is Matsya Purana. Matsya Purana is very important from the perspective of a researcher. Why is this? Because Matsya Purana contains Purana Anukramani. That means it contains the index of all the 18 Mahapuranas. And these Puranas have been arranged systematically by Vedavyasa. So nobody can change what it looks like. So nobody can change any of the Puranas. And it gives the contents of all the Puranas. So the contents of all the Puranas have been mentioned in Matsya Purana. So nobody can tamper with our Puranas. So that is the greatness of this Purana. So it's very important for all the researchers to check out this Purana. Next is Kurma Purana. Kurma Purana is narrated by Mahavishnu himself in the form of tortoise when he comes out during the Sagar Manthan, the churning of the Milky Ocean, when the Devas and the Asuras fight for the Amrita. So the main theme of this Purana is Advaita. It also talks about Maya. And if Maya is in the wrong hands, what can happen? And if Maya is done by Mahavishnu himself, what are the consequences? Next Purana is Markandeya Purana. Markandeya Purana talks about Durga Saptasati, Chandi Yagam, Devi Mahatyam, etc. Navratras are going on, so these are very important things for all the people who are Shakti Upasakas. But this is also an interesting Purana in the sense that this is narrated by Markandeya Rishi. And it begins with the story of four birds who know the moral notions of right and wrong. And it's in the form of a question and answer. It talks about some stories like why was Vishnu born as a mortal? Why were Draupadi's sons killed when they had Krishna and Arjuna to support and protect them? So these kind of some moral questions are answered in this Markandeya Purana. Next comes Vamana Purana. The avatar of Vishnu in the form of Vamana is described in this Purana. So the next Purana is Bhavishya Purana. Matsya Purana actually extols the values of Bhavishya Purana. Here, Mahatmya of Sun is mentioned. Aditya, we pray to Sun God. So that is mentioned in Bhavishya Purana. It also talks about Aghora Kalpa. And this Mahatmya of Sun is described by Brahma himself. And there are stories of events which will happen in the future period. So that is why it's called Bhavishya Purana. Now the next Purana is Agni Mahapurana, which praises the importance of Agni, a form of Vishnu. It is actually an encyclopedia of Alankara Shastra or Lakshana Shastra, figures of speech, literature, poetics, worship of Vasudeva, Sankarsana, Pradyumna, Aniruddha, Narayana are also mentioned in this Purana. And the Navarasas, like the Srungara Rasa, Raudra Rasa, Hasya Rasa, all these things are also mentioned in this Mahapurana. Medicine is also discussed in this Purana. Skanda Purana is again a very important Purana. This Purana talks about Satyanarayana Vrata Katha. And this Mahapurana is divided into 7 Khandas. Maheshwara Khanda, Vishnu Khanda, Brahma Khanda, Kasi Khanda, Avanti Khanda, Nagara Khanda, Prabhasa Khanda. This describes the ancient Indian history. It also gives the geography of ancient India, Bhuvana Kosha. It talks about the Himalayan region, the Kasi Khanda, the Kedara Khanda, Badrikashrama. It talks about Ayodhya, It talks about Tirthayatras that we undertake. It basically gives the complete geography of India. Every inch of our country is mentioned in Skanda Purana. Skanda Purana is very important. So with the help of Skanda Purana, we can actually reconstruct the history and geography of our ancient Bharatvarsha. Devi Bhagavata is also considered a Mahapurana, where Srividya Upasana is mentioned. The next Purana is Linga Purana. Linga Purana preaches about the greatness of Lord Shiva and Linga Puja. It talks about the manifestation of Nandi. It also talks about Dhruva, the great devotee of Shiva. Linga Purana also talks about Daksha Yajna and immolation of Kamadeva and wedding of Lord Shiva, etc. So you can see this video in the description box as well as in the link above. I have made a video about this previously, so you can go ahead and see that video as well. Next comes Varaha Purana. Varaha Purana talks about the incarnation of Vishnu as Varaha Avatara when he has to save the earth from Hiranyaksha. It also talks about differentiating between sorrow and happiness. It talks about the appearance of Yama, description of the court of Yama, etc. Garuda Purana is one of the Vishnu Puranas, Vaishnava Puranas, which talks about death, afterlife, liberation, and Papa, Punya, how is Naraka, and what are the kinds of punishments you can expect in Naraka, and who is Yama, the Lord of the Underworld, who is his assistant, Chitragupta, and all these things. It also talks about liberation with the help of yoga and devotion. It is actually a conversation between Vishnu and his Vahana Garuda. So this is about Garuda Purana. And the last Purana is Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavata Purana. So Bhagavata Purana itself will require a video. So in the next video, we'll see more about Bhagavata Purana. But Bhagavata Purana is the last Purana written by Maharshi Vedavyas, and it is considered as Purana Sara. That means it has all the virtues of all the other Puranas put together. It has 18,000 shlokas, and it is the most, you know, well-known Purana across India. So till now, we have seen briefly about the various Ashtadasha Mahapuranas. So Rishi of the week is Vidyaranya Swami. I would like you all to find out more about Vidyaranya Swami. Who was he? What did he do? And what was his contribution? So he is a great Rishi, and it is very important that we know about Vidyaranya Swami. So the question of the day is, which kingdom did Vidyaranya Swami help in establishing? So let me know the answers in the comment section. Many of you have answered very nicely about the questions that I've asked in the previous video. So if you have liked the video, please give a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel. And do follow me on all the social media platforms. I've updated the quiz section on my website www.zestinimbu.com. Please go ahead and answer the new quiz questions. I hope you answer all of them correctly. So in the next video, let's talk about Bhagavata Purana. So until then, Namaste.